This was a single institution, single center phase two trial. And the treatment was patients got decitabine 20 milligram per meter square for 10 days for induction. And once they achieved either CR or CRI, we could drop it to decitabine 5 days for maintenance or consolidation. Patient got venetoclax throughout, but we did a bone marrow on cycle one, day 21, and if that showed blast clearance, we held venetoclax to allow for count recovery. And on the subsequent cycle, venetoclax could be reduced further, less than 3 weeks, less than 2 weeks, in cases of myelosuppression. And of course, venetoclax was dose reduced for patients receiving concomitant CYP3A4 inhibitors like azole antifungals, which are pretty standard for most patients with AML and neutropenia. We had multiple cohorts in this study. One cohort was older, unfit patients with newly diagnosed AML. That included patients who were older than 60 years. Apart from that, we included patients who had secondary AML from prior antecedent hematological disorder. Of course, we had relapsed refractory AML. They did not have an age cutoff. And we also have a cohort of high-risk MDS with 10 to 20% blasts, and irrespective of prior therapy. And the most important aspect of this trial is that we excluded favorable risk cytogenetics patients like core binding factor leukemia, acute promyelocytic leukemia. So all patients needed to have ELN 2017 intermediate or adverse risk cytogenetics. And based on the encouraging results we have observed in this trial, we have added a new cohort of younger patients with newly diagnosed AML.